Children, how many of you know where is Shimla? Yes, Shimla is in Himachal. See, we all know, children, that Europeans had come from, you know, cold areas. So they were not able to adapt to these weather conditions in India. So what they did, you know, by the later half of the 19th century, Shimla, you know, became the summer capital of the British Raj. British soldiers, merchants, civil servants, all of them, they moved each year to escape from the heat during the summers in the Indo-Gangetic plain which was there. Now, all these things, the pre-independent structures such as the Viceregal Lodge, the Auckland House, the Gorton Castle, the Gaiety Theatres, they all remind us of the British rule in India. I hope these archaeological sources are also clear to all of you. Now coming to the last in the list, that is coins. Children, coins, they also provide us important information regarding various rulers. These provide us information regarding the economic condition of the people. How many of you know that, you know, Humayun, if I am not wrong, had given, you know, permission to make coins, to make money of leather. Children, you know, the British East India Company, they started minting coins from the mid 17th century, and by 1707, the British obtained the right to strike their own rupee in the name of the Mughal Emperor. Now that is why, you know, if you look at the, you know, European coins, you will find the figures of the rulers, or, you know, something symbolic to their countries in the coins which are there. Like in our country, if you see the coins, they have got different, you know, symbols embossed in it. Like if you look at the rupee, the currency note which is there, the several new amendments, new things have been added to the currency note in India.